Hello, welcome back, it's Lynx. Today we're talking about finances in pursuing a music career. I have many videos talking about finances and this is yet another one. COVID is still here and will be here probably forever. Especially right now, it's January at the moment. Things are really laying low because there's a huge surge. It makes things really tough financially for everybody. As a freelancer, I am specifically in a pretty tough financial situation right now, as I'm sure many of you are as well. Navigating this, I know I talked about a new job that I was starting this month, but you know, that's been pushed back. Okay, so you're faced with a few challenges, and at first I was like quite stressed out. I got a car, got an apartment, gotta eat, there are things to pay for. Take a breath, first of all, just like take a few breaths. It's a challenge. It's a boss battle in a video game. Think about it like that. COVID's the boss. Can't die. So it's just eternally there. All right, so if you just have to avoid this boss, not let it catch you, go around it and go to your destination that you need to go to, even while it still lives on, what is the strategy you're gonna take to make sure that you get to that destination, you get to the other side? Things in person are really tough because a lot of people are catching COVID. Quite scary to be in the presence of other people at the moment. I already caught it and have been out of isolation for about a week now, but I was isolated for like 10 days and that was really tough. And I couldn't go in person to teach my students. That was a financial hit for me, for sure. So as I talked about in a previous video that you can check out here, which is all of these different ways to make money online as a musician, I'm kind of resorting back to, okay, I really need to be able to fall back on making money just online, just in case things like this keep happening, and they will. In-person scenarios, especially if you're a teacher, if the classes you teach aren't able to be taught online or people aren't signing up because it's scary, you need to be able to fall back on other things. So I'm back here. Teaching private lessons online is like the most stable of unstable jobs that I have as a musician. I would like to be making more. So the reality is, if I had enough students per week, I would be absolutely fine financially. Like, that's the reality. For me, the problem is just getting the students. That tells me that one of the strategies I need to do better is to market my services more. Literally, that would be enough to make a stable income and to pay all my bills, and then still obviously be able to make music too, and along with everything else, like make these videos, etc. So I'm gonna put much more energy into, you know, marketing myself as a teacher, as well as trying to build up my Patreon. If you're interested in starting a Patreon or want to hear more about that, it's basically just a subscription-based service in which your fans can pay you directly for the music that you make and support you directly. I have a video on this, please check it out up here. I will specifically link my Patreon down below, and I'm gonna put it right down here at the bottom of my video. Please consider supporting my Patreon if you like my videos and the music I make. It would really help me, especially right now. I post a lot of demos, a lot of behind the scenes stuff there, a lot of like mixing, production tips, updates, vlogs, unreleased songs, songs in progress, all of that good stuff. So please consider supporting if you are interested. And the other thing is commission work, big projects. I recently raised all my prices for commission work because I'm worth it. And you need to start telling yourself that too. You are worth the higher price tag. You just are. If I think about how many years I poured into doing this and making it somehow work for as long as I have, yeah, I should be charging way more for the services that I provide. Don't be afraid to up your prices because you are worth it. Think about all of the years of expertise you have in what you're doing in your service that you're providing. And don't be afraid to charge how much you really think that you deserve. That's something I was really afraid to do and held off doing for so long. What does that tell me about how I think of myself? That's the mentality that needed to change for me for this type of stuff. I needed to start really believing in myself and really believing that I was good at what I do to start making actual money off of this stuff, or a livable income. So instead of thinking like, oh my God, I'm struggling financially, like it's not working, I'm doing everything wrong, like I'm the problem. Instead of going down that spiral, which we all can do, you need to think about, okay, this is an opportunity. I'm worth this much more, and I'm gonna start charging that much more. And I truly believe that the service I'm providing is worth that amount because I pour my heart and soul into this stuff, and I've been doing it for so many years at this point that I've lost count. So don't be afraid to up your prices. You are worth it. You're worth the extra money. It's your time. It's your area of expertise. You've worked so hard for this. This is what you're doing for a living. Start treating it like what it actually is. So aside from all those facts, for so long, I just believed that I was worth so little. And sometimes I just have to like slap myself a little bit. Why do you think of yourself like this sometimes? And I've been doing a lot better adopting this mindset that this is a job, this is a business. It must be treated like one. You need to have like blind confidence in what you're doing, like honestly. And then charging more will just be an offshoot of that. Sometimes I have trouble comparing myself to some of my friends that work in like corporate offices and make so much more than I do. And it's like embarrassing when I think about how little I make compared to them. If I really truly just list all the work I do, it's a fucking lot of work, okay? So the YouTube videos, filming them, editing them myself, thinking of what I'm gonna talk about, all the work that basically goes into having a YouTube channel, that's so much work in itself, okay? YouTube's a lot. Two, then you've got like Instagram. You got the reels, you got stories, you got posts, you got TikToks, you got social media, like Twitter. Staying on top of all your socials as an artist is extremely important. So there's all of that. So making videos for TikTok and for reels, and like that's a whole other thing that's really similar to YouTube, just on a smaller scale, but still just as much work. Teaching private lessons, keeping track of schedules, keeping track of what they're learning, where they're at, setting up lesson plans, keeping on top of that every week, doing commission work. So getting sent other people's music and having to write over their stuff or produce for them. This new job I have, teaching babies basic music competence, that's a whole other thing. Early childhood music development for kids. Keeping up with my Patreon and making sure that I'm posting to that every week. And then there's also actually making the music itself. Being able to produce, write, collaborate, have it mixed, mastered, all of that stuff too, writing lyrics, that's the main thing. But actually, you know what, at this point it's not even the main thing I do anymore. It's kind of like a side thing that I do because I need time to do all these other jobs. There's so much more too. There's marketing the music, there's that I have a whole playlist on that you can check out. Basically, I have like 15 plus jobs that I'm juggling. I'm all over the place doing multiple things all the time. And I think about how this is all fueled by this like blind dream that I have. It feels so out of reach, this dream I have to make this work. When I think about like the passion behind all of this, you know, it really does make everything just feel so worth it. As hard as it is, and as little as I make right now from doing like 15 million jobs, there's no other reason than that I could be doing this than blind, like a blind desire to make it work. If I didn't have that, I would be working a corporate job or whatever and making way more than I make right now. You have to also just think about how much you really want this and how much you're willing to put in for very little in return for a while until it eventually kind of gets to a stable place. And then it won't, it'll fluctuate all the time unless you, I don't know, figure it out how to always make it stable, which is totally possible. All of this is fueled by this love for music. Sometimes I get really stressed out about how little I make, but then also I am just like in awe of the fact that I make anything at all from it. You know what I'm saying? Like sometimes we can just be so hard on ourselves and there's hustle culture and there's just like work, work, work. And then when you just don't see the numbers kind of add up to where you'd like them to be, it's really easy to be hard on yourself. But the fact that you're literally making money at all from your dream, your passion, is something a lot of people can't do or decided not to do and just unreachable for them too. So like if you're comparing yourself like I do sometimes, just stick with it. If you don't know anyone else dealing with this, know that I am and I'm with you. It's fucking hard, yeah. You just have to stick with it. You just have to stay consistent. And as hard as it will be at times or all the time, it's possible to make it work. Building it all up takes a ridiculous amount of time. I started releasing music in 2015. So almost 10 years at this point. Okay, so 8 years. 8 years. I've been pursuing this and I'm still struggling financially. So if you're in a similar place after 8 years, you're not alone. I keep thinking to myself, yeah, damn, if I had like 5 more students, I'd be like, A-okay, you know? Just be gentle with yourself. Stay in it for the long run. I really think you're gonna be happy you did. shift your mindset. Treat it like a business, because it is. And I know that's really annoying to hear. I hope that that statement affects you in a positive way. The way I mean that is that you're worth it. You're worth charging more for what you do, basically. Like and subscribe if you want to stay updated on my videos. Again, please consider supporting my Patreon if you're interested in diving even deeper into what I do. Share this video with a friend if it helped you and you think it would help someone else as well. Stick with it, and I will see you next time.